The first thing you're gonna do is you're gonna line your bike up here. We're gonna push the bike straight up here. He's gonna check to see if your balance is good, pushing your bike in neutral. Before he does that, he gets you to do the signal lights, left and right, the horn. He wants to do your high beam, your low beam. Then he goes to the back of the bike. He checks your rear brake to see if the brake works, the brake light. Then he checks your front brake to see if it's hooked up to the sensor and it engages your rear brake light here. Then he gets you to do the kill switch. He gets you to run it in neutral, then pop the kill switch, turn it back on. Then he gets you to push the bike in neutral with the engine off the whole way up here, pushing it very slowly. He walks beside you. Then there's a little stop box here. It's like a square. He gets you to put the front wheel in the center, the very center of this box. See this box? Put the front wheel in the center. Stop. The engine's still shut off. He's talking to you right now. Then he gets you to keep the bike in an upright position, not slanted a little bit to the left, upright. Then he gets you to push the bike in neutral. Then you stop the bike right here, where the front wheel's lined up with that pylon, stop the bike. Then he does the amount of steps, one step, 1.5 steps. So he checks the radius, the turning radius of your Harley Davidson, your Enduro, any kind of bike you have, and then he memorizes how hard it's gonna be for you. That's why he does it, to check how difficult it's gonna be. When you stop the bike here, he's gonna get you to push it in neutral again. Push it in neutral beside these cones. Don't go through those cones like an S, that's later. Push it through here, and then you're gonna curl. Just doesn't matter where, you just do a little curl around, U-turn. Stop the bike again. Now you're actually gonna drive through this part. You're actually gonna run the bike, and then you're gonna slowly take off in first gear. You're gonna run only from 0 to 5K an hour by grinding the clutch and riding the rear brake. So you're not really, the word grinding is wrong, and you're mostly just using the clutch. It's not really that hard on the clutch because the engine's not spinning fast, but you're supposed to be like not riding that very fast, as slow as possible, by using the clutch, always at the friction zone, you know? And also ride the rear brake to keep your tension on the rear chain so it's stiff. Then you're gonna stop with your front wheel in the center of the cones. Again, here we are, your front wheel's in the center of the cones. Then what he wants you to do is he wants you to actually do a rolling U-turn. See those cones there? Do a rolling U-turn. So you're gonna go straight up here, only in first gear, ride the rear brake, ride the clutch. I guess you could use the word ride the clutch. Get it in that friction zone. You're not hard on the clutch. It seems strange. The clutch can take it. Don't worry about it. And then you keep rolling. You don't stop. But you don't go on the left of that cone. You go on the right of the cone. When you go on the right of the cone, you're going to go through here, going very slow, first gear, riding the clutch, using the rear brake at the same time. Again, use a lot of clutch, a lot of clutch. As you squeeze the clutch toward you, you're actually slowing the engine down. You're actually slowing the bike down, millimeter by millimeter. If you want to slow it, pull the clutch in. If you want to go faster, let the clutch out. Then you're going to stop right when your rear wheel passes the last cone. And see, this is these cones in a row? When your rear wheel passes the last cone, then come to a slow stop. Put your left foot down, keep your right foot on the rear brake. Then you're going to do it one more time. So you're going to come around here this time. You're going to go to the right here this time. Then what you're going to do here is you're going to start this direction. So the pylons are there, you come to the right. You just do any kind of curl around turn you want. You bring the bike right up to here, and this is an L, the letter L, right there. You're just going to stop the bike here, wait for a signal. He tells you to start, you're going to start. You're going to roll forward, and then in first gear, you're going to cut left, using that a lot of clutch, Then at the same time, a lot of rear brake, like I mentioned before. Here's how we're going to do this. You're not going to stop anymore. You're going to keep rolling. No stopping. Keep rolling. Keep rolling. This time you're still going slower. You're still using that clutch. You're using the friction zone the whole time. 0 to 5 kilometers per hour. You're not going to get up past 5. So the key to this is having it so you don't put your feet down. Never put your feet down the whole exercise for your MST test. Don't put your feet down. But also go as slow as you can before you put your feet down for some of the start maneuvers, some of the very early maneuvers. This is how we're going to do it. Then you're going to stop here. Then he gives you a signal. You come around, do the U-turn one more time. Then you're going to go to the right of the cone, which is this side. Go right through here, right through here, right through here, S-turn. Always using a lot of clutch, a lot of clutch. Here we go. This exercise here is not putting your feet down. You don't put your feet down at all until you stop. Now, when your rear wheel passes this last cone on the slalom, you're gonna stop again. Then he's gonna tell you we're no longer turning left here again. We're gonna go right this time. This is another maneuver. We're going to go right at these cones, then we're going to stop right here. When we stop right here, we're going to wait. He's going to talk to you. He's going to say maximum 25 to 30 kilometers an hour going straight up this way. Now, your bike, you can keep it in first or second, your choice. First or second, it doesn't matter, depending on what kind of bike you have. So dead stop, he explains here. He's on your left side here. He explains what to do. So you're going to come around the corner, it's an L here, starting off in first. Now we're no longer going slow, we're going faster. So go through here, get up to second here, revving the engine out, shifting about halfway through, about now. Then we're going to take this curve here, and you curve around here. You go on, obviously on the inside, on the outside of those cones. CBR, the 2007, you're coming around this corner, you're going to go through here, and then don't stop at that stop box. That was before. This time you go right through the stop box, and you're going to give it a little shot of gas just before the stop box, get up again, you're 25 to 30, and then you're going to let off on the gas about halfway through this route here. Then you're going to watch for his signal. He's going to relocate his body over here. You're going to look for the guy's signal. He'll use an arm signal saying stop. Then around this cone is the final cone on the slalom. This is when you start engaging the brakes, compressing the brakes. This is when you start braking. That's a way to remember it. He will wait till you're at that last cone. You can actually brake earlier. It's your choice. But when your bike is at this last cone, then he'll flag you to stop. That's one way of remembering it. It doesn't matter if you remember this part. From this last slalom cone here to where he stands is 7 meters roughly. Or from this cone to the very last cone over there, it's 7 meters. So it doesn't matter. You don't have to remember this part. I'm just saying there's cues and points he uses to remember. That's when he starts you to slow down. Then when you start slowing down, you're going to do something called a hard stop, but don't lock your rear wheel or your front. You're going to do hard braking with no locking. Now, when you come to a full stop here, right here, full stop here, he's going to get you to do it again. You have two shots at it. Then you come around this corner here. Well, first you stop completely. Then he says you can try it one more time. You're going to come around this corner here. You're going to stop here. This is your second attempt. I'm going to run you quick stop here. He's gonna be right there. Then he moves his body over there once you start out. So full stop here. This is your second attempt. You go in first gear, right here, popping in the second. If you got a Hayabusa or a Heartbreak or something, okay, keep it in first. Then curl around, keep it in second, curl around these pylons here. And then you're going to keep it on the right of these pylons. Keep it in second, let off on the gas, obviously, throughout that curve. You're not giving it too much gas. You're coasting more than before these four. You start giving a shot of gas, accelerate back up to your 25 to 30. So 25 to 30 there, 25 to 30 here. Let off on the gas wherever you feel is necessary. Right when the very last slalom cone, that's when your front of your wheel, he flags you stop. Then you do such a sudden stop. You lock up the brake. You don't lock the brakes. You start squeezing, progressively squeezing. And you do, I would say, 90% front brake, 10% back. Because if he hears your back wheel skid, then he calls that skidding. So we use 90% front brakes, 10% rear. Come to a complete stop without skidding, but it's pretty hard. And then he passes you. There you go. It's been 10 minutes and 45 seconds. That's the MST test. It's very quick and very easy. And he talks you through it. He has a very, very good calming. He doesn't tell you how many times, he doesn't threaten you. He doesn't say the worst. He only talks about the good things. And you should pass first try, no problem. Thanks for listening. Take care.